If you take a steel section, let's say a steel bar, and then we apply forces in this direction, P and P, then this steel section goes into tension. I can give you an example, a rubber band. If you try to pull it apart, it tries to push your fingers together like this. So same thing happens here. This steel section tries to work against this force. So basically this steel section is in tension. And now if we take a concrete column, with support at the bottom, and if we apply a force at the top, P, then we will have a reaction, P, and this section goes into compression because this section tries to work against the force we are applying in this direction. So basically this concrete column is in compression. Concrete is good in compression and steel is good in tension, hence why we use rebar in reinforced concrete. If you take a cross section of a reinforced concrete beam, we add rebar at the bottom for a scenario like this. If you take a simply supported reinforced concrete beam, and if you try to apply, if you apply a load P here, it would try to bend like this, and the bottom surface goes into tension and top surface will go into compression. Hence we use rebar at the bottom and concrete at the top.